Hello and welcome to another Nikomedia tutorial. So today we will recreate this year PlayStation Plus connection from from PlayStation. What a surprise! And this small animation here we will make. Got the question how to do this, and this is pretty simple, but it's a nice effect, so I want to show it. So let's. This seems, okay. It looks like this here. We do just this spinning thing here, and yeah, and we will texture it as well. I think we will, let's see how long we need. It should go quite quick here, and yeah, I texture it in I think in physical render, because let's see. Here you see some. It looks like some light shines through, and here we have some light. Let's try. I did not try it, so let's try to get something like this effect, maybe. And yeah. And I would like to make it in R23, but OTOY still didn't get it, so. OTOY just asked what's happened with the support for R23. The question was, we make a break, please be patient. This is a good answer. I will tell this my client, hey, please be patient. What else? Okay, so let's make this in R22. You can do it with older versions too. This is, you can do it only with almost every version here. And I start with the simple, I show the effect because I have some very impatient follower. It's okay, totally. And if you just want to see how the effect works, and you are not interested how to make this shapes or something else, or this symbols, I show you just the effects, how the effect works, and then you can decide if you continue watching or not. So okay, so as I said, first the effect is pretty simple. Let's make this with some tubes here. Let's go here to 50, zero. Let's make here 50 as well, and give it here to 60. Okay, make another one, 60, 70, another one, control drag down is a copy, 70, 80, and another one, control drag down, 80, 90. Then you put this whole thing in a fracture object. Zip. Okay. And the fracture object, you select the fracture object and you give it a step effector. So in the step effector, you see, because I have already selected the fracture object, the step effector is in here. If it isn't, so just drag it in. In a step effector, we want, on the parameter, we want just effect the rotation. And here, the rotation P is a 10, and you see, sorry, we get this one here. And now you would say, okay, hey, just let's rotate the step effector, we have our effect. Yeah, it is like this, we just have to rotate the step effector. But the only thing is, go in the parameter, the transform space, to effector. And now, whoops, this is our effect. Okay, that's it. So for the people that just want to see the effect, how it works, you know it now. And now we start the tutorial, and let's delete this. Good. I have somewhere, wait a little bit, let's bring in Shift F6. I have a screenshot of this thing here. Open image. Nope, not here. I need it. Desktop. Whoops. Now come on. Desktop. Screen press. So here. I have this guy here. So that we have something to watch. So we need, I start with the inside here, with the inside, and the, we make it like this, and we do the symbols and everything. Okay, so let's hide this for the moment. Okay, I go in top view and I make a rectangle. Let's bring here in the work plane, so and let's make it 100 by 300 should be fine. Okay, and R for rotation, and I hold my control key and rotate it, and I hold my shift key as well so that I have increments, and rotate it at 90 degrees, and the control key was because so I get a copy here. So I have this, and now we need a spline mask. Bring this to the spline mask, go to the axis along Y, and you see we have union, we get this X shape. And just go to the spline mask, hit first, let's see the rectangles. No adaptive we need known here, that doesn't, we don't need it. And hit C on the keyboard to make it editable. So this is our cross, let's see. And now wanna bring in this here a triangle, here a rectangle, here a circle, and here an X. Oops, here an X. So far so good. So let's make a triangle spline. Spline. Inside with three sides should be a triangle. Rotate it 90 degrees. Make it smaller, T for scale, and we bring it up to this point here. So I hold my shift key so I get increments and set it exactly to here. This size is not the right now, I'll do it later with the rectangle here. So make it rectangle, T for scale, bring it here to the this point here and go closer. T for scale, and I see how far I want to scale it. Let's go here to 30 by 30. We're exactly inside here. And then we need an outside as well, but I think that looks good. Okay, 30, 30 is okay. And now I take my inside here, move it over to this point here. So let's go to snapping. This out here, work plane snap point line. Okay, so I snap this to here, and now I don't need a snap here, I think. So, but some T for scale, I just want the same height, so something like this. Okay, this is the same height, little here over it, and it is okay. E for the move tool and move it back to its position. So nice, need no snapping anymore. Now let's make a circle. This rectangle was 30, so this circle should be 15 in the thing. Okay, and we need the X. The X should be later a little bigger, so let's wait with the X. Now we need to outline these things, and there is a wonderful free plugin. You will find it in the description of this video, and it's named here Outline, Spline Outline. What this does, it makes an outline, of course, but you are able to change the distance later on. So you can change it to every time you want, and this is exactly what I want. So I want an outline for the rectangle now, and for the rectangle, for the triangle, not for here, not for the circle, because for the circle we need it a little different, because Otherwise, we would get shading problems. I want no interpolated points here and here, all linear and not interpolated. And here I want it in Bezier and adaptive. So otherwise, we would have here a linear thing, and then we could get problems with the shading. So I simply drag in these two guys here. You see, we immediately get an outline here. Let's make an outline 10. Perfect. Look at this. And now I do the same with the cross. So you can copy this and delete out these guys here. But in the circle here, I want uniform. Yeah, uniform is okay. And this is what I want here. That should work so. But we can change it later. We shouldn't have to make it editable. And it's me. I always want to stay parametric as long as I can. So, and then copy this rectangle here. Bring it to here. Okay. And make it the width 10. This is the 10 here and the 10 here distance. And I drag it back to here. Enable snapping again so that we are in the middle here. So, then I rotate it 30 degrees, 45 degrees. Oops, we should adjust the green one. So, 45 degrees. And now I make it long like so that it is here and here. So, go up here, should be about 70, 70. Nice. E for the move tool. Bring it back to here. Don't need this anymore here. And R, hold your control key to copy and hold your shift key 90 degrees. Okay, so we have these two rectangles here. This is our X. Bring it again in a spline mask. Oops. Again in the Y-axis. And uniform, that's it. And we can say sieve, and we have it. Here we need no linear, that's okay. Good, we have our symbols. Maybe they're a little too big, huh? I'm not sure. Yeah, but it's okay again. We can change this later because it's only this one will not, but we can, but it's okay for the tutorial. Or no, it is too big. It is too big. Don't like it. So then let's go to the and go to 20 by 20. Yeah, that looks much better. You see, that's the great thing with the outline thing. We can make the same here with the circle. 10. Okay, and here again we simply drag our inside in the middle of here. So. Enable snapping, I can do it with simply S or Shift S is enable snapping is Shift S. And drag this to here. Make this something like that. T for scale. Yeah, that should be okay. I want just that this rectangle has almost is the height of this triangle. E and bring it back to our position here. Yeah, this I like much more. This I like more. Or should I go so far that it, let's see how this looks. As I said, I did not test this, so I just thought, let's do it. I have an idea how it could work, and TFSK. So that is this height, almost this height, okay. E. Bring it back to here. Oh, this is too small. The inside is too small to get back. Okay, that's fine. And again, we have to make the X. Copy the rectangle. Make the rectangle here 10 and the width. Rotate it 30 degrees, 45 degrees. This, okay, and then go to the rectangle and make it longer. So 65, this is okay, 56 is okay. And then bring it to here. Shift S to disable the snapping tool. R for rotation, control key for copy, and hold the shift key 90 degrees. Whoops. Again, spline mask. Hope it's not too fast, but it's quite simple. So, and with the spline mask and something that we worked often in our tutorials, so normally everybody should know it meanwhile. So, okay, that's nice. See, let's first see. Now, see here. And yeah, okay. Fine. Yeah, that looks better. That I like more. Good. Now we have this all here. And now this is our cross. This is our splines. Good. I want the cross and these things, the symbols in a spline mask. So what I need now is first a connect object, and I want to connect this all our symbols here, and name this symbols. We should save maybe. Desktop is okay. Yeah, why not? So PS for PlayStation. What is this trailer? Dude. Okay. Now we need a spline mask. Bring in the cross. And the symbols. That looks horrible because a long Y. And here, instead of union, we go to OR and we have it. And this spline mask we already can extrude. And we have this wonderful thing here. And this is exactly what we want. Extrude it 50. Yeah, I want it downside, that's okay. And that's nice. And of course we can you could go here to caps and round the caps a little bit if you want. But then you don't have a rounding here. You want here a rounding as well. So and if you do it like this, your object becomes bigger because that paper goes outside. This is something I don't like. In the older versions you have a constraint, you had a constraint, but in the newer versions you don't have it anymore. I don't know why, but anyway, maybe it works in R23. I haven't a look, but doesn't matter. We can put this extrude in a null, so Alt G. And under the null, doesn't matter. And under the null, we need a bevel deformer. I hold my shift key so that the bevel deformer becomes a child of the null. You see? And here we go to 3. You see we have some, but here you see we have now a rounding. But we have some shading problems here. And we can get rid of it maybe. Bounding, rounding, zack, zack. Okay. So we don't need this for the moment. Now we start to make the outsides here. So we have our cross. Make a copy of the cross, so control on your keyboard and drag the cross outside here. So we have a copy. And I name this simply one. This is the spline one, what comes out, and 2, 3, 4. And we can close this and hide it maybe. So here again, we take our outliner. So outliner, spline outline. I hold my Alt key, so the spline outline becomes a child of this, a parent. And let's see how thick we want. Is this seems to be too thick? 10. Let's see here. Maybe 12. 12 should. I think 12 is nice. But I forgot something. Yeah, I forgot something. Delete this spline here. This we need later. This is okay. But I go back to my extrude. It's a cross. Disable this for the moment. The cross point. I want in the points. I want then little bevel. You see here. We have a small bevel here. So a chamfer, not bevel. So we want this, of course. And this cross now. So now we have the points here. I select all the points with Control A and 0 on the number calais here on the keyboard, and Control drag over these ones. Because I want just the outer ones chamfered. So right click, chamfer. Let's see how. No, come on. Right click, chamfer, and hold your left mouse key and drag it. And I would say 5 is a good number here. But you see, okay, this is not round here. The reason, let's go back. Back with Control C, you go back. The reason is this cross. We have the intermediate points to PCA, so sort of known. We need here. Let's make it adaptive. Now, I think 20. No, let's stay with 5. We have so few polygons, or so few geometry inside. That doesn't matter. So again, right click, chamfer. Now we have a round chamfer 5, and you will see. Now it's nice round, and everything should work as did before. Yeah, I see. At this we could go to 20 here. See, then we have less. Let's go to 10. But it will become bigger and bigger as more we extrude here. So let's stay with 5, doesn't matter. Why not? Okay. So now I copy out this cross here, control drag it out. Whole thing here, and now bring it in the outline, and you see, okay, that works. So we have the first thing here, the first outline. So we can extrude this. I want to extrude every extrusion separately, so we can put it later in the fracture object. So I want to make a extrude. I think we made here 50 or something else. Yeah, 50. Here 52. And it goes in the wrong direction. We want it under the floor. To achieve this, it's easier. Go to your cross here, to the spline. In point mode, and right click and point order and reverse the sequence. So now it's down here. So that should fit exactly with this one. See? Perfect. Good. The next one is we copy this one, the whole extrude. Let's name this extrude 1 so we know this is the first thing here. And then I copy everything, name it extrude 2. But now we have to do something, and hide this extrude. I don't hide the extrude, hide the null, so that we hide this extrude, and we have this one now, and I don't want to see the extrude. What I need now is the outer part of this one. So that means when I need the outer one. So I go to my spline outline. Say current state to object. I have it here in my toolbar, but you can right click and you have it current state to object. Now we have it here. This is now this spline, and I want the outside. So what I do is I go take the cross, say explode segments. Then we get this here, and this one is the outside. I take this, delete this and the other two, can delete this one and bring this inside, and now I have this one. So, and this fits exactly with this one, but you see again we have here a wrong point order. So right click, you have to be in point mode for this, don't forget this, reverse, and you see everything fits exactly together. So we do this two times more. So I go to my extrude. Now I know how it works, so we shouldn't have any problem with this. So I go to my extrude, drag it down. 3. I don't know what that shows, but and I need this spline. Current state to object, bring it out, then I delete this one. Here I just say explode segments. I know the last one is it. I can name this 3 so it looks a little better, and bring it under here. Wrong point order. Reverse sequence, and we have the next one. And one more, slowly, and so that everybody sees it. Copy the extrude, control drag it down. I need it 4. Don't care what you see about here. So. Then I need here spline, I need this outline spline, so current state to object. So, can delete this one. Then explode this one. The last one is the one we need. Name it 4 and bring it back. Point order, reverse sequence, and we have it. Bring back this extrude here, so this null. Bring out the bevel for the moment. So we don't need the null here, so okay. Everything should work fine so far. That looks good. Now, I want this whole thing in a fracture object. So we have extrude, this is the inner part, or the name, let's name it cross. Can write it. And let's make a fracture object. Zip. Bring all of them in the fracture object. Zwing. Nice. And now we take the step effector with the fracture object selected. Go to MoGraf, effector, step effector. And you see the step effector is in here. because we have selected it before. If not, drag it in. Step effector, we need the rotation. It's 10 here. That works. And we know we need now this rotation of the step effector does not work at the moment. See? We have to go here to the node, from the transform space from node to effector. Now this thing works. Okay, let's animate this rotation of the effector. So we got the step effector coordinated, and this is this one. So on frame 0, you see I have 100 frames here. On frame 0, I make a keyframe, go to frame 100, 360 degrees, and make another keyframe. So we have now this animation. But in the original one, the cross moves as well. So when we have a closer watch, you see the cross moves as well. So let's do this. How can we do this? So we go to our step effector. Under effector, we have here a min max. Open this and simply bring the minimum to minus 100. Now we have this crazy movement. Don't forget to save. Great. Next step, we want the bevel of all of these things. So let's bring the fracture object in the null here. Let's bring the bevel under the null. We have a bevel on everything here. And that's simply great. Of course, now it moves much slower because we have a lot more geometry here, but doesn't matter. You could now still, I think we could now in the extrude here, go here to 20. Oh, this is the wrong one, I think. So good. Oh yeah, let's go here to 10. And if this is too much, this is the cross. Got here, go to 20. So that looks nice, I think. Okay. Yeah, save. Here is 3. We have 3, I think. Huh? Yeah, 3 is okay. Maybe make a little bigger one. I think that looks better. But it's on you. You can do it however you want. So now we need a floor around this whole thing here. Good. That means we need the cross again. We need this cross again. This is the outline of this. No, we need the last cross, the biggest cross we need. So that means make this one editable. You see this spline here? Make this one editable. Bring it out, explode it. We just need the outside of this. Explode. This last one is the outside. We know it meanwhile. And name it floor. So you see, we have this guy here. Let's disable the step effector for the moment. And you see here, we have the outside. We can hide everything here. Good. Now we need another rectangle. Make this as big as you want. 1500 by 1500. Fine. And bring it down to the floor. In a spline mask. Whoops. A long Y. And let's see. No time at the moment, sorry. You see, we don't see it, so let's go from union to or. Does not. Something is wrong here. Why is this? Or should work normally? Ah, I'm stupid. Or works, but I haven't seen the rectangle. So you see, or works. Okay, we can now extrude this here. Whoops, extrude down to minus 50. Oh, in the other direction. Yeah, we could now, of course, again reverse the spline, but let's go to 200 here in the other direction. Doesn't matter, so we don't see this. And now, normally, let's bring this extrude Alt G in a null, so with Alt G, and take the same bevel deformer here. And now, in the bevel deformer, it's important, what I forgot to say, it's important that you have use angle ticked on. Otherwise, it would bevel every single edge you have here. And this is, of course, not what we want. So be sure this is ticked on. Okay, and if we bring back this null, should perfectly fit inside here. And if you, oops. Let's bevel it more. So of course now we have some intersections normally, not at this part, but when we are this, we should have some intersections like here. No, it doesn't intersect. Oh, that's crazy. Okay, no intersections. If you have intersections, don't care. No, simply go in the floor here, T for scale, and you can scale this spline up and make it bigger. Okay, save it. This is the whole magic behind it. So we want it. Now let's find a nice spot, so something like that, I would say. And I don't want to see through this thing. Of course, we could now bring in a plane and then make a plane a child of this, and or we could model this. But the easiest way to get rid of this so that we don't see through is in the cross. Go here to 200 or something else, and we don't see it through anymore. The same we can make everywhere, so make very big numbers here, let's say 200 everywhere, so 200. Okay, and now let's say this is the spot I want, so something like this. Bring in a camera, zack, and protection deck. Oops, what's wrong here? I changed the script because the script does not work in R23. Now it works in R23 but not anymore in R22, because I have everything on one place. The whole thing, also the whole scripts, plugins, everything, so that it doesn't matter which version of Cinema I have, everything goes to the same path. So, but it doesn't matter, nothing easier than that. Just search for it here, or Shift C and protect. Yeah, so protection deck. So double click it, and I have it here. Okay. Save it. Now we could start to simply animate. Does it here. Yeah, you see here we have a intersection. So that means I go to my floor extrude here, T for scale as I said, and make it a little bigger. So something like that. Good. Nice. Save. How does it look? Shift F6. Yellow and gray. Good. Yellow and gray, we should be able to do this. It's not really yellow, it's just orange yellow. So make a new material. And color something like an orange yellow, so maybe up to 50 should be. Yeah, okay. This is fine. Bring it on the cross. Okay. This is the cross. Okay, we will see it, but so. And this is gray. And now gray is gray, means we need gray. Oh, something like this. To the extrude. Dun, dun, dun. If you don't want to do it like this, you can, there is another way. You can go to the material, to the assignments, select here what you want, and simply drag it in here. So, you have it. Okay, now the render will look terrible. We have no lights, no nothing inside here. But we see it works so far. Of course, I'm gonna render with GI, and for GI, we need something. We need light, we need reflections, we need a Nicomedia scene rig, of course. Yikes, Nicomedia scene rig. We don't need here anything, we just need the reflections and everything. So, and this should already look better. And it does. Wow. Hey, that looks nice. Maybe we should go down with the reflection, because the original one has almost no reflection as far as I can see. There is almost not the shadow. I don't do the shadow. The shadow is ugly here. This is, and I don't like the lights as well. So this is, I don't think this is nice. At least here, this is the render. Then I don't like, I like the effect, but I don't like this render, honestly. But doesn't matter. So it's quite simple. So in the scene rig, you could go, of course, in the materials, and you can select both materials here and go to reflectance channel and go up with the roughness, go down with reflection so that you don't have any reflections. You get this look. But you also can, if you work with the scene rig, you can also go to the scene rig and to the HDRI settings. And here in the reflection brightness, bring it down. Yeah. And you have no reflections at all. You don't even have to go in the material settings or something. But I want some reflections. We don't have to make it exactly like they did it. So good. So far, so good. If you want these ugly shadows, let's see, so that we get some shadows. You can use a sunlight or a normal light or whatever you want. And let's see, let's go a little down here. So minus 50. Okay. And I activate simply the sun here in my rig. The sun, where is the sun now? Let's go out of the, so we should, let's hide the camera, I don't want to see it. When we go here, you see, this is the dummy for the sun. I want the sun from here, so go to detonation, so minus 90 degrees. And I want to have it a little up, so just show it this here. Yeah, here you have the sun. The sun, of course, is far away from it. And here is the rotate vertical. You can, so the sun comes from here. Now we should get some shadow here. Let's go in. The shadow type is at area. This is okay. You see, we have some shadow. Let's go a little down here, so then we get the longer shadows. Maybe go a little back here. Yeah. Well, we have almost shadow here, so if you want the shadow as dark as it is here, so simply we can go in a little. Oh no, no, a little. Oh, so. Okay. Just go up with the density of the shadow. So we have here the area shadow. There should be a density here. 200, as we'll see. Whoop. Get a black shadow here. But that looks not so bad. Our shadow looks better than their shadow. We can do it with a soft map. Let's get soft shadows. They render faster, but I think they don't look so nice. Okay, area shadow. And of course, it's now quite dark in here. So for such a render, we have to change a little bit in the render settings. If I have my render settings, you will have here, everywhere I show you is with the medium set and with the middle settings, middle GI. In the global illumination, we have just Quasimodo, Quasi Monte Carlo, Quasimodo. We have just a Quasimodo. We have Quasi Monte Carlo. Most times it's enough to render, but in this case, let's you see it's quite dark in here. First, we can deactivate the ambient occlusion. It's still dark. So a secondary method, we can use a light mapping. You see it getting brighter here. Let's see if this depth has any. It's okay, light mapping, let's go here to 10,000. It will not make a lot of difference. Don't like your Indians cache, let's try. Yeah. We can, let's see what we get. No, no, the light mapping is the right one. Radios on the map, radios on the maps. No, no, the light mapping. Okay. And yeah, of course, it's dark here because of the shadows, of course. So let's go to the sun. But we could try deactivate the sun for the moment and let's see how this looks. Now that looks better, I think. Yeah? Let's stay for the moment with this. I want the gray a little darker. And because it's my gray, I can make it darker whenever I want. I never would do it with your gray, of course. But it is mine. Good. I think to the original one, the Shift F6. The bevels are much harder here. So let's go to this bevel, to the first one, and go back with this to 1, I would say. I Yeah, this is better. The outside I want with two. This is okay for me. But this is nice. Okay. I think we see through here. So let's go to the extrude here and make it even. Let's go to 500. Doesn't matter. Yeah. Now we don't see to the floor. Yeah, that's nice. So how do we get something like this in physical render? We could try different things. We could try to make it light under it and let it shine light through. But I don't think that this looks nice. So now this tinkering starts. And I don't do it Octane today, so I just do the physical render. If you want an Octane, it would be much easier, the whole thing, because this is only because you have a real life preview and you know what's done here. You have to think around and wait a little bit, and if you play with light it needs longer. But just try it, why not? We have a little time, why not? Don't know how long we record, but I think it's about 1 hour, not even 1 hour, so we have time. So what did I want to make it light. Let's try this. A simple light here. I don't want to see it in the editor. And it should be, please, an area light. So, I almost never work with lights here. I always work with HDRI, but sometimes you have to. So we have an area light here now. Let's see. Area light is E, and where is it? Of course we can't see it because here is our area light. Okay, we need to rotate it 90 degrees. It's both sided, so it doesn't matter which direction, and it needs to be bigger. T for scale, and make it bigger than the cross, of course. So this is, it's good. And I bring it now down to somewhere like here, let's say. Of course we don't see it now. And let's see what we get. Yeah. It lights from under it. That's not bad. That's not bad. But let's see the details. I want inverse fall off, so. And make this way smaller. We get it. We have here a nice light. Shift F6 to see the original one. Such lights, we get it here, and of course we have to play with it. But let's make the outlines a little smaller so that maybe that the light can shine through the outlines. So that means I need it just for this four extrudes here. So check, check, check. I need the outline splines. I will make I selected now all four spline outlines, all four, not all four. So let's hide this for the moment. And I want to make a selection object out of this, so I don't have always to go there and pick it. So I go to select, selection filter, and selection object. So now I have here a selection object with these things. I can close all and deselect everything, so I click somewhere in here. And if I want this selection, I just say restore selection. Now I have all, you see it, I have all my outline splines here, and I don't have to open on something or something else. So let's make this 10. And that's the great one with the plugin. We never could do this when we make an outline with the right click and outline. This is we want a render piece. Yeah, we get light through it, but maybe This was nice. This was nothing. So, only 20. We won't see much. But with 200, let's see if we could get a light. It makes no difference. But it does not shine through. Let's see. Selection. Restore selection. Make this a little smaller again. 8. We don't get. Yeah, we get light here. Maybe we should make the light a little brighter, but I'm afraid this will. It looks interesting. Of course, we have a very low render here. You see, we're in a preview and at 50% here. So what you see here is not. But what we can try is here. Well, that's okay. That looks not bad, but the gray is of course. Of the because of the light too bright. Yeah, this is on you. I don't want it with the light, honestly. So if you wanted to, this is the first thing you could do it. But I delete the light. I don't want it. And yeah. No, of course I have to. There is another thing we could do. We could work with an luminance material, maybe. So I go to here and take a luminance, and here we were at 50. But of course, it's far too. You see. It's not so nice, but we can make it on the bottom here. We have the luminance, and on the top it's less. So let's go to the texture here and bring in a gradient. You will see what the gradient does. We have on the black side we have less, and here, but this is not what we need. We don't need it in V as well. This is the wrong direction. What we need is a 3D gradient, so 3D linear. The moment it's not the correct way, we don't need it here, we need it in the Y axis. This is X, X, Y and C. So 0 here, 0 there. And let's try now. Let's go drive here from 50 to -200 for the moment. You see it in the preview with dark and bright. You see it here. So to see it with the color, just go to here to normal to multiply. And we get light. We get light, we get light, we get light. We get nice light. So let's go here to 0. Oh, no, so we don't see anything. 100. Yeah, that looks nicer. Give it a little color. Look at this. We have nice light here, a little bit of light here. Look at this. What could we do even more? This is This is nice, but I want it darker on the, so go to 50 here again, so it should get darker on the top. Let's again here to 10. Yeah, okay, that works. So I'm gonna go back to 100 here, not to 10, to 100. And simply make the luminance a little less bright. I think this is not a bad thing. This is by far not a bad thing. That works better than I thought it will. Honestly, with this we could play and play and play and play and play. Let's see if it will get here the diffusion, luminance, and bring in a Fresnel here maybe. Effects. No, where is our Fresnel? Here's our Fresnel. Invert the gradient maybe. Yeah, now we get darker edges here. I think, let's see. Yeah, you see, so we see almost the edges, we don't see it really. Now, with the diffusion on it, we see it much better. We can go crazy a little bit. That makes fun. Yeah, 200 was a fun thing. Why not? And now let's go crazy. Portal light it samples a little better, as I said, with portal light you get a little better. And it needs longer to render, you see it. And you can go with the GI even higher. This will be too high, but let's see. Yeah, so if you want this with this light thing going, you can do it like this. You see the way now how to do it. But as I said, I don't wanna do this. I want my nice. I don't want. What's going on here now? I deleted the luminance. Well, I do have the red things here now. I deleted the light. And it's red now, that's interesting. Why does this now? That's crazy. Why I have this now? Yeah, it should work more often with this physical render. It makes still fun. And is the light map is known? We get the black thing here. Oh, it is with the second quasi on the corner. Yeah, that's almost better. Because I want a little darker, it should be darker and if it's deeper. Let's make a render here. I have no idea why it is shining now at the moment. We don't have anything inside. The diffusion, delete the diffusion, so maybe. Maybe the diffusion does something, but it's not activated, so it could do nothing. Anyway, so I wanna make here little GI, zack, zack, quasi Monte Carlo, that's okay, that's okay. And make a small render, 720 is okay, and hit R. Yeah, of course, now we get a bad thing here. Oh, we have to go to 100 here. So this is not really a nice render. Let's try it a little bit. So we go here with the light mapping, Shift R and render it. Let's go. I think it does not matter a lot. I see a difference, but I still not sure why does this should. Now I make another material, so I make this gray material, make it yellow, and bring this gray material onto here. Let's see if this is the same. Yeah, this is, no, it is not. This is just the correct one. This is exactly the same material. Reflectance 700, this is okay. Only color with 50. Was here is exactly the same. 50 and reflectance, so exactly the same material. Something is so, but doesn't matter. I delete this and name this cross. So easy it is. We have a nice thing here going. And as I said, if you want it with a little sun here, activate the sun, render it. But of course with the sun you get. But here, normally, we could try. Oops, no, I don't want this. I want this here. Night mapping, let's go to 64. Yeah, you see a difference, but I don't know if it's with the sun, yes or no. It looks not bad, but do I like it? You have to decide how you want it. But now what I want again is I want to close the gaps here between. So selection, restore selection, go back to 12. And render it. Yeah, you see it renders quite fast. Yeah, I stay with this. I like this. And we have our thing. If you really need an octane thing for this, I will play with it. But yeah, I play with it anyways. So if you're Patreon, if you're a patron, you can download the project file later. And in the project file, I will do Octane Render as well. So if you are interested in the Octane Render, just download the project file and you see how I did the material and everything. Yeah, that's it for now. I will make later an animation of this. Or I render some, I make a break and render some frames so that you can see how it looks. So delete this everything. I make a short break, we will be back in a second. So I am back and let's see what we get. Yeah, that's the reason I think I would do it without the sun, so the shadow here, this is, but the movement is great. Okay, I think we can be very satisfied with this one. Okay, so that's it. As I said, I will make an Octane version, but only for download. So it's not really a problem here, because the Octane materials for this are very easy, and bringing a light from downside, this shouldn't be a problem. I have to think around as well. So yeah. But I honestly prefer it without the sun and without light. Simply, I will make a render again with HDRI. Okay. So as I said, this I will bring the link I will give you in the subscription for the outline plugin, for the spline outline. And yes, that's it. Yeah, if you want to support me, as I said, you can do so on Patreon, link in the description, and you can download there then all my project files, not only from tutorials. Sometimes I do some private work or something else, and I give the project file as well, and other downloads and so on. Just have a look at it, and or if you say, I want to just donate once or something else, I am very happy with this as well. You can do so at a PayPal link you will find in the description as well. If you have questions, requests, complaints, let me know. Write it in the comments, write it on our Facebook group or on my Facebook site or on my homepage or somewhere. Wherever you can find me, you can write me, and I honestly try to answer every question and everything. But sometimes I overlook something, or I just don't get the message or something else. So just when I don't answer in, let's say, about 2 days or something else, simply ask again or write me again. So it's no problem. But don't spam, please. Good. That's it for now. Have a wonderful evening. It's now here. You see it. It's a quarter to 10, and yeah, next tutorial will come to 99% on weekend, and there we will play with some splines and simulate an airflow and something else. This is a question from a patron, and of course this is the next one. Good. So yeah, have a nice day, all the best here, stay healthy, all the best here from Vienna, and tschüss. Und Papa.